What is a portable ladder? A portable ladder is a ladder that can readily be moved or carried, with side rails joined at predetermined intervals by steps, rungs, cleats, or rear braces. When properly selected, erected, and used, portable ladders temporarily. Proper use of portable ladders. 1. Ladders must be visually inspected prior to their use. The user is responsible for the inspection. Ensure that safety feet are in place and that there are no rungs lost or loose, and no damages that could cause personal injury. Use a ladder that has a safety feet. 2. Choose the right length ladder. It should be long enough so that you can work standing, not above the fourth rung from top. You should not stand on a ladder with your knees extending above the top rung and never use the top rung. Do not overreach from a ladder. If your buckle reaches past the uprights, you've gone too far. Move the ladder. 3. Defective ladders must be immediately removed from service and promptly tagged not to use. 4. Step ladders are positioned on firm and level surface when used. 5. Straight and extension ladders are held by a second person during the initial ascend until top of the ladder is firmly secured for subsequent climbs. Make sure nobody bumps into it. 6. Keep both hands free of tools and other items as you need both hands to climb. Wear a tool belt or pull materials to you after reach the top. Face the ladder while ascending or descending. 7. Ladders are placed to allow a minimum 1-to-4 ratio between horizontal and vertical. It should be placed one rung length out from the wall for every 4 rungs where the ladder touches the wall. 8. Make sure that ladder is supported on a firm and strong structure, and not on any pipes or conduits. The uprights of a ladder should be vertical. Shore up if the ground is uneven. In an incident, a worker placed a ladder leaning against a conduit. While climbing up, the conduit broke. He lost balance and fell down and got injured. Subsequently, a chain of events occurred. The wires inside the conduit were damaged, causing a short circuit. UPS power to the unit was lost. Unit tripped, causing production loss and process upsets. When using a leaning ladder to carry out a task, only carry light materials and tools, read the manufacturer's labels on the ladder and assess the risks. Don't overreach, make sure your belt buckle, navel, stays within the styles. Make sure it is long enough or high enough for the task. Don't overload it, consider workers' weight and the equipment or materials they are carrying before working at height. Check the pictogram or label on the ladder for information. Make sure the ladder angle is at 75 degrees. You should use the 1-in-4 rule, E1. Unit out for every 4 units up. Always grip the ladder and face the ladder rungs while climbing or descending. Don't slide down the stiles. Don't try to move or extend ladders while standing on the rungs. Don't work off the top 3 rungs, and try to make sure the ladder extends at least 1 meter, 3 rungs, above where you are working. Don't stand ladders on movable objects, such as pallets, bricks, lift trucks, tower scaffolds, excavator buckets, vans, or mobile elevating work platforms. Avoid holding items when climbing, consider using a tool belt. Don't work within 6 meters horizontally of any overhead power line, unless it has been made dead or it is protected with insulation. Use a non-conductive ladder, e.g. fiberglass or timber, for any electrical work. Maintain 3 points of contact when climbing, this means a hand and 2 feet, and wherever possible at the work position. Where you cannot maintain a handhold, other than for a brief period, e.g. to hold a nail while starting to knock it in, starting a screw, etc., you will need to take other measures to prevent a fall or reduce the consequences if one happened. For a leaning ladder, you should secure it, e.g. by tying the ladder to prevent it from slipping either outwards or sideways, and have a strong upper resting point, Do not rest a ladder against weak upper surfaces, e.g. glazing or plastic gutters. You could also use an effective stability device. When using a stepladder to carry out a task, check all four stepladder feet are in contact with the ground and the steps are level. Only carry light materials and tools. Don't overreach. Don't stand and work on the top three steps, including a step forming the very top of the stepladder, unless there is a suitable handhold. Ensure any locking devices are engaged. Try to position the stepladder to face the work activity and not side on. However, there are occasions when a risk assessment may show it is safer to work side on, e.g. in a retail stock room when you can't engage the stepladder locks to work face on because of space restraints in narrow aisles, but you can fully lock it to work side on. Try to avoid work that imposes a side loading, such as side on drilling through solid materials, e.g. bricks or concrete. Where side on loadings cannot be avoided, you should prevent the steps from tipping over, e.g. by tying the steps. Otherwise, use a more suitable type of access equipment. Maintain three points of contact at the working position. This means two feet and one hand, or when both hands need to be free for a brief period, 2 feet and the body supported by the stepladder. Falls from portable ladders, step, straight, combination and extension, are one of the leading causes of occupational fatalities and injuries. Read and follow all labels, markings on the ladder. Avoid electrical hazards. Dash look for overhead power lines before handling a ladder. Avoid using a metal ladder near power lines or exposed energized electrical equipment. Always inspect the ladder prior to using it. If the ladder is damaged, it must be removed from service and tagged until repaired or discarded. Always maintain a 3-point, 2 hands and a foot, or 2 feet and a hand, contact on the ladder when climbing. Keep your body near the middle of the step and always face the ladder while climbing, see diagram. Only use ladders and appropriate accessories, ladder levelers, jacks or hooks, for their design purposes. Ladders must be free of any slippery material on the rungs, steps or feet. Do not use a self-supporting ladder, for example, step ladder, as a single ladder or in a partially closed position. Do not use the top step, rung of a ladder as a step, rung unless it was designed for that purpose. Use a ladder only on a stable and level surface, unless it has been secured, top or bottom, to prevent displacement. Do not place a ladder on boxes, barrels or other unstable bases to obtain additional height. Do not move or shift a ladder while a person or equipment is on the ladder. An extension or straight ladder used to access an elevated surface must extend at least 3 feet above the point of support, see diagram. Do not stand on the three top rungs of a straight, single or extension ladder. The proper angle for setting up a ladder is to place its base a quarter of the working length of the ladder from the wall or other vertical surface, see diagram. A ladder placed in any location where it can be displaced by other work activities must be secured to prevent displacement, or a barricade must be erected to keep traffic away from the ladder. Be sure that all locks on an extension ladder are properly engaged. Do not exceed the maximum load rating of a ladder. Be aware of the ladder's load rating and of the weight it is supporting, including the weight of any tools or equipment.
Thank you. Please give comment and suggestions.
Thank you.
Subscribe our YouTube channel and hit the bell icon for more updates. Thank for visit our channel. See you next class.
Thank you.